Dear brothers and sisters, as we continue our study of the Word of God on the book of Revelation, let us pray. Priya sahodara sahodariyani, elidarau pote Bible adhyayane api karagena yana athare dan yaajñavakin aarambha karu.
Priyamana sahodara sahodarigale, வெளிப்படுத்தல் புத்தகத்தில் தியானத்தை நாங்கள் தொடர்ந்து செய்து கொண்டு செல்லும் முகமாக நாங்கள் இப்பொழுது ஜெபம் செய்ய போகிறோம்.
Our gracious loving heavenly Father, our great and almighty God, God of peace, God of great and unfathomable love, we come to thee, we call upon thee in the name of our loving Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, the one who paid the penalty of our sin on the cross, and the one who rose again from the dead, and the one who ever liveth to make intercession for us. Loving Father, we thank thee for the blessedness of knowing thee. Lord, it is such a saddening thing to think about the innumerable companies of people who are lost and who are without Christ, without God, without hope in this world. Loving Father, what a great privilege thou hast given us to become thy children. But to a vast majority of people, true and the living God is not known. They are strangers to the commonwealth of Israel. They are completely aliens to all the manifold graces of God. Lord, it is such a sad thing. We pray for every one of them. O God, have mercy upon our neighbors, upon our relatives, friends, and others around who do not know thee. They will have to one day stand before the great white throne judgment if they do not come to thee now. O God, help us that we may lead responsible lives, that we may take the responsibility of conveying the message to them. Loving Father, at the same time, we think of the greatness of the experience of salvation and experience of the grace of God in our lives. How much we have enjoyed the fellowship with God, who said, "Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hears my voice and opens the door, I will come into him and sup with him, he with me." Thou hast kept thy promise. Lord, we are now enjoying that fellowship with the Lord Jesus, the Spirit of God indwelling us. Loving Lord, we know so much of thee and so much from thy word. Lord, we are enjoying now and we will enjoy in the eternal future. Lord, we are eternally grateful to thee. Lord, words cannot describe our sense of gratitude for the greatness of the great salvation. So as the divine revelation tells us, how can we escape if we neglect a so great salvation? Help us, Lord, that we may accept this wonderful gift and hold it so sacred and dear as we walk through this life, the great salvation thou hast given us. Now, loving Father, help us to understand some signs of the end times, some details further revealed in the book of Revelation. Lord, we confess our inability and our lack of knowledge. Yes, Lord, very little that we know. We pray that thou will bless that little knowledge we have. Thou will bless, Lord, the little ability that we have to understand thy word and use it to equip us, to enrich us, and to strengthen us, and to edify us, and to prepare us for thy soon return. Hear and answer our prayer. We give thee all the glory in the name of our loving Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen. Among the four stages of God's judgment that will come upon the world during the tribulation time, there are other important things mentioned from Revelation chapter 6 to 19. දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ දිව්‍ය උදහස සහ විනිශ්චයන් අදියර හතරකින් පොළොවට පැමිණීම ලියා තිබෙන අතරතුර තවත් වැදගත් කරුණු එළිදරව් 6 සිට 19 දක්වා සඳහන් වී තිබෙනවා.
දෙවනුඩේ න්‍යාය තීර්පුහල් 4 කට්ටங்களாக උපද්‍රව කාලத்துக்குள் வரும் காலத்திலே அதற்கிடையில் நடைபெறும் சில முக்கிய சம்பவங்களும் வெளிப்படுத்தல் 6 அதிகாரம் தொடக்கம் 19 அதிகாரம் வரை உள்ள பகுதியில் காணப்படுகிறது.
You can make it 10 point description or 12, 14 or even go up to 16. But the important thing is to notice some of these things and learn something about the tribulation time. මෙය අංක 10කට සීමා කරන්න පුළුවන් 12ක් කරගන්න පුළුවන් 14ක් හෝ 16ක් විදිහට ඉගෙන ගන්නත් පුළුවන් වැදගත් දේ නම් මේ කරුණු ගැන යම් අවබෝධයක් ඇතුව සිටීමයි
ඉතින් නාගල් 10 குறிப்புகளாகவோ 12 14 அல்லது 16 ஆகவோ நாங்கள் இவற்றை வேறுபடுத்திக் கொள்ளலாம் ஆனால் முக்கியமான காரியம் என்னவென்றால் இவற்றை நாங்கள் கண்டுகொள்ளுவதே
We were at point number 10 The unholy Trinity and the battle at Armageddon. අප අංක 10 වෙනි එකේ හිටියේ කරුණේ අපි හිටියේ අංක 10. එනම් අශුද්ධ ත්‍රිත්වය සහ Armageddon හි යුද්ධය.
නාගල් 10වද කාර්යයේ குறித்து பார்த்து கொண்டிருந்தோம் அசுத்தமான ත්‍රිත්වමும் Armageddon இல் யுத்தத்தை குறித்தும்.
Let me read to you some startling passage from the book of Isaiah chapter 63 Isaiah 63 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයේ මම ඔබට තිගැස්සෙන සුළු දේව වචන කොටසක් කියවන්නම්
Isaiah 63 ஆம் அதிகாரத்திலிருந்து சில வசனங்களை நான் வாசிக்கின்றேன்
These words describe to us The ultimate, the climax of the wrath of God. අපිට පදවලින් විස්තර වෙනවා දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ උදහසේ තීන්දුව කෙලවර උපරිමය.
අංගේ නඟ කානුන්ඩෝ දෙවනුඩේ කෝපාකිණයින් අවරුඩේ උක්‍රත්තින් කඩයිසි කක්කතේ නඟ කානුන්ඩෝ.
Isaiah 63, 1 to 6. Isaiah 63, 1 to 6 දක්වා.
ஏசாயா 63 ஒன்றிலிருந்து 6 வரை
Who is this that cometh from Edom with dyed garments from Bozra? This that is glorious in his apparel, travelling in the greatness of his strength. I that speak in righteousness, mighty to save. Wherefore art thou red in thine apparel, and thy garments like him that treadeth in the wine fat? I have trodden the winepress alone, and of the people there was none with me. For I will tread them in mine anger, and trample them in my fury, and their blood shall be sprinkled upon my garments, and I will stain all my raiment. For the day of vengeance is in mine heart, and the year of my redeemed is come. And I looked, and there was none to help. And I wondered that there was none to uphold. Therefore mine own arm brought salvation unto me, and my fury it upheld me. And I will tread down the people in mine anger, and make them drunk in my fury, and I will bring down their strength to the earth. Dear brothers and sisters, this is a scene that is prophesied concerning the revelation of the Lord Jesus Christ, his second coming. Meya Swami Bhu Yesu Kritu Vahan Sege Devani Paminima Elidharavu Vata Adalavu Darshanaya Vistaragaradima
Idu Anavaragi Yesu Kristi Nude Irandam Varagai Avarude Velipadukku Sambandhamana Oru Vibaram.
We will see further details of this later, because we are going to consider, God willing, the glory of Christ in his revelation. At the moment we are considering glory of Christ during tribulation, but glory of Christ in revelation, we will refer to these points, these details. Me kiyamu kotasa api thawa wedi vistareka yedenta yanawa Yesu Kristu wahansege elidaraw wimeedi unwahansege mahimaya දෙවනි පැමිණීම එළිදරව් වීමේදී උන්වහන්සේගේ මහිමය සලකා බලන වෙලාව දැනට අපි සලකා බලමින් ඉන්නේ උන්වහන්සේගේ මහිමය පීඩා කාලය තුළ.
නාගල ඉදේ කුරිතදාන මේලදිග විවරංගල් ආණ්ඩවරාගිය යේසු ක්‍රිස්තුවினுடைய இரண்டாம் வருகையில் அவருடைய மகிமையை குறித்ததான காரியங்களை பார்க்கும் பொழுது பார்த்துக்கொள்ளுவோம். ஆனால் தற்போது நாங்கள் பார்த்துக்கொண்டிருப்பது உபத்திரவ காலத்தில் ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவினுடைய மகிமையை குறித்தே.
Though all the details may not be correctly understood at the moment, now we know that at the end times, during the tribulation, the last part of it, there will be three evil spirits going to deceive the people, the kings of the earth, who will come together into the land of Palestine for the final battle, to the place which is called Armageddon. සියලුම විස්තර එකින් එක નિවරදිව අප අවබෝධ කරගත්තේ නැතත් අපට පොදුවේ දැනගන්නට දැන් හැකි වෙලා තියෙනවා. පීඩා කාලයේ අවසාන කෙළවරදී අසුද්ධ ආත්ම තුනක් ගිහිල්ලා මුළු ලෝකේ රජවරුන්ව රැස් කරලා එක පිටියකට ගේනවා. එනම් හර්මගෙදොන් කියන ස්ථානයට අවසාන යුද්ධය පිණිස.
இதை குறித்ததான எல்லா விவரங்களையும் நாங்கள் சரியாக விளங்கிக் கொள்ளாவிட்டாலும் ஓரளவு நாங்கள் விளங்கிக் கொண்டிருக்கின்றோம். அந்த கடைசி அந்த நாட்களில் மூன்று அசுத்த ஆவிகள் சென்று பூமியின் ராஜாக்களை பலஸ்தீனா தேசத்துக்கு விரோதமாக ஒன்று சேர்ந்து அந்த அர்மகதோன் என்ற இடத்தில் ஒரு யுத்தத்துக்காக ஆயத்தம் செய்யப்படுகிறது.
இந்த புக் ஆஃப் டேனியல் சாப்டர் 11 ஸ்டார்டிங் அட் வெர்ஸ் 36 we have a parallel description of that. Abada tibena Daniel 11 parichchede 36 wenni padayen aarambha vela idiru kotase tibena e pilibanda samantara pahadili kirima.
Daniel 11 adhigaram 36 vasanam todakkam irukkum pahudiyil adakku samandramana oru veda vasana pahudiyai kaanapadugirathu.
Kings of the north, kings of the east, kings of the south would come. And the kings of the west, not mentioned, but they are the people who will be with the beast, the world ruler at that time. එහිදී වෙනවා උතුරේ රජවරු, දකුණේ රජවරු, නැගෙනහිරින් රජවරු ගැන සඳහන් කරනවා. බටහිරින් රජවරු ගැන කියලා නැහැ නමුත් අපි දන්නවා ඒ තමයි විරුද්ධ ක්‍රිස්තුස් වන මේ මුර්ගයා සමග ඉන්නා වූ සේනාව තමයි බටහිර රජවරු.
අංගේ නංග කාණපඩුරෝම් වඩක්ක දිසෙයිලිරුඳු වරම් රාජාක්කලේ කුරිතුම් තෙන් දිසෙයිලිරුඳු වරම් රාජාක්කලේ කුරිතුම් கிழக்கிலே இருந்து வரும் ராஜாக்களை குறித்தும் சொல்லப்படுகிறது ஆனால் மேற்கிலிருந்து வரும் கூட்டத்தை குறித்து சொல்லப்படாவிட்டாலும் நாங்கள் அறிந்திருக்கிறோம் அது மிருகமும் மிருகத்தோடு இருக்கிற இராணுவமுமே
What happens at that battle is described in passages like Isaiah 63 Zechariah chapter 14 Second book of Thessalonians chapter 2 and also in passages of the book of Revelation ema yuddhayedi sidu wenadi vistara vela thiyeno Yesaya 63 wani paricheda Zechariah 14 wani paricheda e wage ma devini Thessalonike devini paricheda athulu elidarau pothe isthama kiyebe
ange nadeiparum kaaryangalai kurithadana vivarangal ஏசாயா 63ஆம் அதிகாரத்திலும் செகரியா 14ஆம் அதிகாரத்திலும் 2 தெசலோனிக்கேயர் 2ஆம் அதிகாரத்திலும் அதேபோல வெளிப்படுத்தல் புத்தகத்தில் சில பகுதிகளிலும் எழுதப்பட்டிருக்கிறது
Today I would like to suggest that you may read at home chapter 17 and 18 of the book of Revelation and read them again and again and try to understand them according to the clues that I would give now. Then ma obata yojana karno oba vela dibena avasthavaka elidarau yali kiyawala yali yali kiyawala utsaha karanna e therum gan me ma dan obata dennavu yam ingi walata anukoola
நான் உங்களிடம் கேட்டுக்கொள்கிறேன் நேரம் இருக்கும் பொழுது வெளிப்படுத்தல் 17ஆம் அதிகாரத்தையும் 18ஆம் வசனத்தையும் மீண்டும் மீண்டுமாக நீங்கள் வாசித்து அதை விளங்கிக் கொள்ள முயற்சி செய்யுங்கள் நான் இப்பொழுது கூறும் காரியங்களோடு தொடர்பு படுத்த முயற்சி செய்யுங்கள்
That will cover the last two points of our this present study. ஏன் ஆவரணிய வெண்ணி அப்பே மீ தன் கரகணையான அத்தியாயே அவசான அங்க தேக
நாங்கள் தற்போது செய்து கொண்டிருக்கும் தியானத்தின் கடைசி காரியங்கள் ரெண்டும் அந்த பகுதிகளில் நாங்கள் கண்டுகொள்ளலாம்
So number 11 is the end of the ecclesiastical Babylon or religious Babylon அங்க 11 இனிசா ஆகமிக பபிலோனிய அவசானம்
11வது காரியமானது ஆன்மீக பபிலோனின் கடைசி கட்டம்
and then number 12 is the end of the political and commercial babylon அங்க 12 தமை தேசபாலனமய சக வாணிஜ்யமய பபிலோனிய அவசானம்
12வது காரியம் தான் அரசியல் அரசியல் ரீதியான வர்த்தக ரீதியான பாபிலோனின் வீழ்ச்சி
This world is moving on for the last 6000 years of known history of man it's moving on disregarding God and his word මේ ලෝකය ඉදිරියට ගමන් කරමින් යනවා මේ පසුගිය අවුරුදු 6000ක අප දන්නා ඉතිහාසයේ මිනිසාගේ දෙවියන් වහන්සේ සහ උන් වහන්සේගේ වචනය සලකන්නේ නැතුව
නාගල් අරින්දිරිකර මනිද වරලාන්ට්‍රින් කඩේ 6000 වර්ණங்களாக மனிதன் தேவனையும் தேவனுடைய வார்த்தையையும் குறித்து கரிசனை கொள்ளாமல் அவன் முன் சென்று கொண்டிருக்கிறான்
The word Babylon is used symbolically to show us the nature of the world today බබිලෝනිය කියන වචනය භාවිත වෙන්නේ සංකේතයක් වශයෙන් අපට அத வர்த்தமான மீ லோகே சுபாவே பென்னும் கரன்
பாபிலோன் ஆனது ஒரு அடையாள வார்த்தையாக இங்க பாவிக்கப்படுகிறது தற்போது இருக்கும் உலகத்தின் சுபாவத்தை எடுத்து காட்டுவதற்காக
இட் இஸ் ரிபெலியன் அகைன்ஸ்ட் காட் தேவியன் மகாந்தர் எரிஹிவ கர்லிக சீமன்
அது தேவனுக்கு விரோதமாக கலகம் செய்தல்
திஸ் பிளேஸ் which is known as Babylon. It was a great city at one time before Christ, but it originated with Babel. Its original name was Babel because that was the place where a great confusion started. Ithin me Babylonia kiyana bhumi bhage nagaraya ඉතා ශ්‍රේෂ්ඨ නගරයක් වතිබුණා ක්‍රිස්තු පූර්ව අවුරුදුවල නමුත් එහි ආරම්භය බාබෙල් වලින් තමයි බාබෙල් කියන වියවුල
ඉඳ බාබිලෝන නගරපඩුගර ඉඩම් ක්‍රිස්තුවුක මුන් නාක්කලිල් මෙහෙම ප්‍රසිද්ධමයින්ද රමයි ඉඳදු ආනාල අද ආරම්භම් බාබෙල් என்ற இடத்திலிருந்தே ආරම්භිකපඩුගරது
that is the place where man said let us get together organize ourselves build a city and a tower that we will not spread abroad on the face of the earth etana thamai minisa kiyuwe api apiyoma samvidhane karagamu api samvidhana vela me polobe visirayan nathi wena vidihata api apitama nagarayak saha kotak godana gaga
ange than manidan koorinan naangal ondru sernde நாங்கள் உலகமெங்கும் சிதறடிக்கப்படாத விடத்துக்கு நாங்கள் ஒரு நகரத்தையும் கோபுரத்தையும் கட்டுவோம் என்று
And God took it very seriously as rebellion against himself and he came down and confused their language දෙවියන් වහන්සේ ඒක බරපතල බර සැලකුවෝ එවැනි ආකාර ක්‍රියා කිරීමක් උන්වහන්සේ විරුද්ධව කැරලි ගැසීමක් කියලා උන්වහන්සේ පැමිණ ඔවුන්ගේ භාෂාව අවුල් කළා
தேவனதை பாரதூரமாய் எண்ணி அதை அவருக்கு விரோதமாக செய்யும் கலகம் என்று அவர் வந்து அவர்களுடைய பாஷையை குழப்பி விட்டார்
so since that time man has been in this habit of organizing themselves under political ideologies or religious ideologies இதா இந்தல மனுஷයාට මේ පුරුද්ද තියෙනවා එනම් දේශපාලනමය මතවාද හෝ ආගමික මතවාද වලට අනුව මිනිසා සංවිධානය වෙනවා
අන්ර දෙඩකම ඉඳ මුරේ කාණපඩුගරදු අරසියල් රීතියාවෝ ආන්මීහ රීතියාවෝ මනිදන් ඔන්ඩු සේරුගරා
most of the eastern religions can be traced back their origin to babel to babylon බොහෝමි නගදීර ප්‍රදේශයේ පෙරදිග තිබෙන ආගම් වල ආරම්භය අපිට ගිහිල්ලා බලන්න පුළුවන් බබිලෝනියෙන් ඇවිල්ලා තියෙනවායි කියන
ක්‍රක පහදීල ඉருக்கும் මදංගල් අනේක මදංගලுடைய ආරම්භத்தை நாங்கள் බාබෙල් என்ற இடத்திலே கண்டு கொள்ளலாம்
man has devised methods to rule himself and disregarding god so both on the religious front and the political front this is going on I think මේ මනුෂ්‍ය තමාවම පාලනය කර ගැනීමට විවිධ පාලන තන්ත්‍ර නියම කරගෙන තිබෙනවා මේ නිසා ආගමික පෙරමුණෙත් ඒ වගේම දේශපාලනමය පෙරමුණෙත් මිනිසා තමාට අවශ්‍ය පරිදි කටයුතු කරනවා දෙවියන් වහන්සේ අතහැර
මනිදන් දේවනේ කයිවිට්ටු පුරගණිත්තු அவன் அரசியல் அமைப்பிலும் அதேபோல மத அமைப்பிலும் மூலமாக தேவனுக்கு விரோதமாக கிரியை செய்கிறவனாய் காணப்படுகிறான்
and we find in the chapters that I mentioned 17 and 18 a description about babylon and the fall of babylon which is somewhat difficult to see and understand correctly interpret correctly අපි පේනවා 14 18 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදවල බබිලෝනිය ගැන සඳහන් වෙනවා බබිලෝනිය වැටීම ගැන බබිලෝනියේ විනිශ්චය ගැන පැහැදිලි ලෙස අවබෝධ කර ගැනීම සෑහෙන අපහසු
බබිලෝනියේ වීල්චියේ குறித்து அங்கே 14ஆம் 18ஆம் அதிகாரங்களில் சொல்லப்படும் காரியங்களை நாங்கள் விளங்கிக் கொள்வதற்கு கடினமான விதத்தில் அங்கே கூறப்பட்டிருக்கிறது
We find first of all in chapter 17, 1 to 7, a woman by the name of Babylon the Great. පළමුවෙන් අපිට 17 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයේ මුල කොටසේ 1 සිට 7 දක්වා හමු වෙනවා ස්ත්‍රියක් 5 වෙනි පදයේ කියන වෙන පරිදි මහා බබිලෝනිය කියලා නමක් ඇත්තා වූ ස්ත්‍රියක්
නාදල් කාන්නුන්රෝම 5 ஆம் வசனத்தின் படி மகா பாபிலோன் என்ற ஒரு ஸ்திரியை குறித்ததான விபரம் சொல்லப்படுகிறது
See chapter 17 verse 5 17 5
பதினேழாம் அதிகாரம் ஐந்தாம் வசனத்தை கவனியுங்கள்
Upon her forehead was a name written mystery Babylon the great the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth That is a very terrible description of this woman is completely rejected by God and bringing displeasure even to read about that description is not easy ethin me istriya gana balagwa apita penawa saha mulinma ashuddha deviyan mahanse aprasanna karana apita kiyawanda tapahasu aakarayata e vistare thiyenne
genanga kanunru melum rahasiya maha babilon vesihalukkum bhoomiyilulla aruvarupargalukkum thai endru sollapadugirathu devanal purakanikkappatta naangal vaasi
அருவருப்பாயிருக்கிறேவலி மத்தலா இன்னவா மே வேத சாட்சியங்கள் லேவலின் மத்தலா இன்னவா
ஆறாம் வசனத்திலே நாங்கள் காண்கின்றோம் பரிசுத்தவான்களின் இரத்தத்தினாலும் இயேசுவினுடைய சாட்சிகளின் இரத்தத்தினாலும் வெறி கொண்டிருக்கிறது
This can be considered the final form of the apostate Christendom more than anything else because of the word harlot mentioned மேஹி வேஷ்யாவக்கின நம சதஹான்வ திபென நிசா மே அபிட தேரும் கண்ட திபென்னே வரதட கியாவு சம்பூர்ணின் சத்தின் இவத்வ கியாவு கிறிஸ்தியானி ராஜ்ய ஹட்டியடை ஏ வேஷ்யாவக்கின நம சதஹான்வலா திபென நிசா
இங்கே வேசி என்ற வார்த்தை அதை குறித்து சொல்லப்படுகின்ற படியினால் அதன் மூலம் நாங்கள் எடுத்துக்கொள்ளக்கூடிய காரியம்தான் சத்தியத்தில் இருந்து புறம்பே போன கிறிஸ்தவ ராஜ்யத்தை குறித்தே
You can see that in verse 3 this woman is carried by the beast the woman is riding on the beast ඔබට පේනවා 3 වෙනි පදයේ බලනකොට මේ ස්ත්‍රියව முருகா விசிந்தமாய் உசுலாகிறது
மூன்றாம் வசனத்தின் படி இந்த ஸ்திரி மிருகத்தினால் கொண்டு செல்லப்படுகிறது
சேம் பீஸ்ட் பிகாஸ் ஹேவிங் 7 ஹெட்ஸ் அண்ட் 10 ஹார்ன்ஸ் அபி தண்டம கதா கரம முருகயாமாய் ஹிஸ் ஹதை அங்க 10 ஏதேனோ
நாங்கள் இதற்கு முன்பு குறிப்பிட்ட அந்த மிருகமே 7 தலைகளும் 10 கொம்புகளையும் கொண்ட
சோ ஹியர் வி ஹேவ் an indication about the final phase of apostate Christendom as it is further and further moving away from the word of God finally during the tribulation time it comes to its final stage of being the great harlot ඉතින් මෙය අපිට ගෙන ගන්න තිබෙන්නේ සත්‍යයෙන් ඉවත් වෙගෙන ගියා වූ මේ ක්‍රිස්තියානි රාජ්‍යය එයි අවසාන අධියර එනම් වේශ්‍යාව බවට පත්වලා සිටිනා වූ අධියර තමයි පෙන්눔 කෙරෙන්නේ.
ඉංගේ නාගල් කාන්ඩුන්ඩෝම් තොඩන්ඩුම් දේවනුඩේ සත්‍යත්තිලිරෙන්දු පුරම්බේ පෝහර ක්‍රිස්තව රාජ්‍යත්‍ය කුරිත් අදන් කඩේසි කට්ටම් අඳ වේශියාහ සොල්ලපඩුගරදු.
There's a good possibility of all the other religions also, in principle, making a united front with this bee or this woman, the harlot. Idathi wenawa me anikut sielu agam dharmayanda me veshyava vannavu me istriya samaga podu sandhaniya kodunada ganeema
idam irukkirathu inda matreya madangal kooda inda veshyaga karandapadum inda istriyodu avargal oru oppandathai seidukolluvargal.
When the rapture takes place, the confusion that would set in at that time among the people would result in not only political unity but also religious unity in the world. Suddhavanthe osawa ganeemat samagam siduvennavo maha viyavuli pratipalayak vanni deshapalana ekamutu bhavayak athi wenawa pamanak nove ஆகமிக ஏகமது பாவேகுத் அதிவென்
பரிசுத்த வான்கள் எடுத்துக்கொள்ளப்பட்டதின் பிறகு ஏற்படும் குழப்பத்தின் ஒரு விளைவாக நடக்கும் காரியம் என்னவென்றால் மனிதர்கள் அரசியல் ரீதியான ஒற்றுமையை மாத்திரமல்ல ஆனால் மத ரீதியான ஒற்றுமை கூட கொண்டு வரப்படும்.
It is clear that this organization of religions is headed by Rome, because in chapter 17 we have the seven mountains also mentioned in verse 9. Abida penawa me 17 padi 9 wini padaye kandu hatak gana sandahan wenawa me aagamika samvidhane moolikatwe ganni Rome ay
inge umada masnathil naangal kanun Rome ஏழு malaigalai kurithu koorapadugirathu. அதனால் இந்த மத கூட்டமைப்பின் தலைமைத்துவத்தை ரோம் எடுக்கும் என்று கருதுறதுக்கு இடம் உண்டு.
ரோம் இஸ் ஆல்சோ நோன் ஆஸ் த சிட்டி ஆஃப் செவன் ஹில்ஸ். ரோம் என்ற கீழ் லபனவா ஹது ஹதே நகரே கீழ்
ரோமை குறித்து ஏழு மலைகள் காணப்படும் நகரம் என்று சொல்லப்படுகிறது.
ஆல்சோ இன் திஸ் ரிவைவ்டு European or revived Roman Empire, obviously the Rome has a very great role to play. Me ubudunu labuavu yali nagitla thibennavu Roma adhirajyayata ehin Roma ena pradhana tanak thibenawa
meendum uyirpattirukkira uyirpikkapadugira Roma perarasil Romavukku oru pradhana idam undu.
Remember, it is the extension of the old Roman Empire. In Daniel chapter 2, the two legs Roman Empire, then feet area is the final phase. Ithin obata matakaadi ara Daniel devini parichchede maha roope darshane paada deka tamai Roma adhirajye ida passe angidi kodasa anna eka tamai இலங்கட யலி விவிதன ரோமராஜ்யம்.
உங்களுக்கு நினைவிருக்கும் தானியல் இரண்டாம் அதிகாரத்தில் அந்த பெரிய சிலையின் இரண்டு இரும்பு கால்கள் தான் அந்த ரோம பேரரசாய் காணப்படுகிறது. அதற்கு பிறகு அந்த பாதங்கள் கலக்கப்பட்டதாய் காணப்பட்டது இரும்பும் களிமண்ணும். அது மீண்டும் உயிர்ப்பிக்கப்படுகிற ரோம பேரரசை காண்பிக்கிறது.
I may not be able to answer all the questions that come up in your mind regarding this chapter 17. මේ 17 වෙනි පරිච්ඡේදයේහි ඔබට පැන නගින ගැටලු රාශියක් තිබේ. ඒවා ඔක්කොම මට සාර්ථක පිළිතුරක් දෙන්න පුළුවන් වෙන්නේ නැහැ.
14 ஆம் අධ්‍යානத்திலிருந்து உங்களுக்கு अनेक கேள்விகள் எழும்பலாம். அவை எல்லாவற்றிற்கும் சரியாக விடை கொடுப்பதற்கு என்னால் முடியாது.
But we can give a general idea about this chapter. නමුත් මේ පරිච්ඡේදය ගැන පොදු සාමාන්‍ය අදහසක් දෙන්න පුළුවන්.
ஆனால் இந்த அதிகாரத்தை குறித்து ஒரு பொது ஒரு விளக்கத்தை கொடுக்கலாம்.
In verse 5, this woman sitting on the beast is called the mystery Babylon the Great, the mother of harlots, an abomination of the earth. මේ ස්ත්‍රියට පස්වෙනි පදේ කියලා තිබෙන 17යි 5 මේ මුර්ගයා පිට ඉන්නා වූ ස්ත්‍රියට ඇගේ නම දෙන්නේ රහසක්. මහා බබිලෝනිය
महाबाबिलोन
immediately we must be able to see the contrast. The church is called the bride of Christ, the virgin bride of Christ. අපි එකවත් අහගෙම මෙතන තියෙන වෙනස සංසන්දනය කරගන්නට ඕනේ. සභාවට කියන්නේ ක්‍රිස්තුස් වහන්සේගේ කන්‍යාවක වන මනමාලිය කියලා.
නාංගල් උඩනේ අන්ද වෙරුපාටේ කඳුකොල්ල වඬුම්. සබේ කුරිත්තු සොල්ලපඩුගිරද ක්‍රිස්තුවින් මනවාටි කන්‍යේ යාන ක්‍රිස්තුවින් මනවාටි என்று.
Second Corinthians chapter 11 verse 2 tells us දෙවෙනි කොරින්ති 11යි 2 අපිට මෙහෙම කියනවා.
Second Corinthians 11:2 ඉපිලි කුරපඩුගිරද.
For I am jealous over you with godly jealousy. For I have espoused you to one husband, that I may present you as a chaste virgin to Christ. So that is the nature of the church. Then ඒ තමයි ස්වභාවයේ ස්වභාවය.
අංගේ නාගල් කාණුන්ரோம் நான் உங்களை கற்புள்ள கன்னியாக கிறிஸ்து என்னும் ஒரே புருஷருக்கு ஒப்பு கொடுத்தேன் என்று. இதுதான் சபையின் ஸ்வபாவம்.
So in contrast we find here a harlot, that is an unfaithful person, not the faithful virgin and the bride, but the unfaithful. ඉතින් එනම් මෙතන අපිට තියෙන්නේ මේ වේශ්‍යාව. එනම් අර අවිශ්වාසවන්ත තනත්තිය. විශ්වාසවන්ත පිරිසුදු කන්‍යාව නොවේ.
இங்கே நாங்கள் காண்கின்றோம் ஒரு வேசியை குறித்து. அப்படி என்றால் ஒரு உண்மை இல்லாத ஸ்திரீயை குறித்து. ஆனால் சபையை குறித்து நாங்கள் காண்கின்றோம் உண்மையுள்ள மனவாட்டியாக கன்னிகையாக காணப்படுகிறது.
That is the reason as to why we suggest that this woman is the final form of the apostate Christendom, also together with other religions most probably. And ඒ නිසා තමයි අපි කාමයන් හඳුන්වන්නේ මේ ස්ත්‍රීන් අදහස් වන්නේ සත්‍යෙන් බැහැරව ගියා වූ කිතුරු රාජ්‍යය ලෝකයේ අනිකුත් ආගම් එකතු කරගෙන පැමිණෙනා වූ.
අදලන් තන් නාංගල් සාධාරණමහ කූර්වද ඉන වේසීන් මූලමහ சத்தியத்தில் இருந்து புறம்பே போன கிறிஸ்தவ ராஜ்யத்தும் அவர்களோடு ஒன்று சேர்ந்து இருக்கிற மற்ற மதத்தாரும் என்று.
We have evidence today, dear brothers and sisters, that any change globally, any change can take place in our religious or political ideologies. අද අපිට තිබෙනවා හොඳ උදාහරණ පේනවා ලෝකේ. මේ මුළු ගෝලීය ලෙස සැලකුවොත් වෙනස්කම් ඇති වෙන්න පුළුවන් වහාම ආගමික හෝ දේශපාලනමය මතවාදවල.
උලමඟුම් පාර්ගම් පොළොද නාගල් කාණුන්ரோம் අරසියල් රීතියාවෝ මද රීතියාවෝ பெரிய வித்தியாசங்களை ஒரே நேரத்தில் கொண்டு வரக்கூடியதா இருக்கிறது.
Yes, it is obvious that since this is connected with Rome as well, the Roman Church will have a prominent place in this organization. ඉතින් මේ රෝමයේ සම්බන්ධතාවයක් තිබෙන නිසා පැහැදිලිවම අපිට කියන්න පුළුවන් මේ රෝම සභාව මෙහි ප්‍රධාන කොටස් කරුවෙක් වෙනවායි කියලා.
ඉගේ රෝම සම්බන්ධපට්ටිරකර පදිනා இந்த ரோம சபை இதில் ஒரு பெரிய பங்கை எடுக்கும் என்பதை எங்களால் கூற முடியும்.
Christendom is not any longer concerned about the doctrinal truths, but they want unity. Christiani රාජ්‍යය අද ඉගෙනීම් සත්‍යතාවය ධර්මය ගැන කරදර වෙන්නේ නැහැ. ඔවුන් කියන්නේ ඔවුන්ට එක්සිට් වීම අවශ්‍යයි කියලා.
ක්‍රිස්තව රාජ්‍යම් சத்தியத்தை குறித்தும் உபதேசங்களை குறித்தும் கரிசனை கொள்ளாமல் இப்பொழுது அவர்கள் கூறுகிறார்கள் ஒற்றுமையே தேவை என்று.
One common denominator, something that will make everybody one across the Christendom, in recent years has been the charismatic movement. Ithin me eka podu sadakayak thibena. Christiani raj khandayam siyalla haraha ounma ekamuthu karanna puluwanmu me charismatic vaadi iganvima.
ஒரு காரியத்தை நாங்கள் கண்டிருக்கிறோம். தற்காலத்தில் இந்த கிறிஸ்தவ ராஜ்யத்தில் அனைவரையும் ஒரு ஒன்று சேர்த்து ஒற்றுமை பண்ணக்கூடிய ஒரு காரியம்தான் இந்த கரிஸ்மெடிக் உபதேசங்கள்.
ஸ்டார்டிங் வித் 1965 அப் டு நவ் யூ மே ஹேவ் ஹர்ட் அண்ட் நோன் ஆஃப் கிரேட் கரிஸ்மெடிக் ரலீஸ் பிரிங்கிங் டுகெதர் ஆல்மோஸ்ட் ஆல் த டினாமினேஷன்ஸ் ஆஃப் கிறிஸ்டியானிட்டி. ඔබ දැකලා ඇති අසල ඇති 1965 න් ආරම්භ වෙලා ක්‍රිස්තියානි රාජ්‍යයෙහි සියලුම නිකාය වලින් නියෝජනය වෙන කණ්ඩායම් එකතු කරලා පොදු රැලි බොහොමයක් පවත්වලා තිබෙනවා.
නික කණ්ඩම් කෙටුම් ඉරිපිරිගල් 1965 ஆம் ஆண்டு தொடக்கம் இன்று வரை இந்த கிறிஸ்தவத்தில் காணப்படும் சகல பிரிவினைகளையும் ஒன்று சேர்த்து பெரிய ரலிகள் அவர்கள் வைத்திருக்கிறார்கள்.
You will see the Roman Catholic priests and nuns worship side by side with the so-called Bible believing Christians of charismatic faith, but their beliefs are far apart. The doctrinal beliefs are so different, but they are together on a common platform making one body. ඔබ දැකලා ඇති රෝමානු කතෝලික පූජකයන් සහ එම කන්‍යා සොයුරියන් ඒ වගේම කැරිස්මැටික් වාදී ක්‍රිස්තියානි බයිබලය විශ්වාස කරනවා කියන කණ්ඩායම් ඔවුන් එකතු වෙලා එකම තැන ඉඳගෙන එකට නමස්කාර කරන ආකාරය ඔවුන් ධර්මය අතින් අහසට පොළොව වගේ වෙනස් ඒ වුණත් ඔවුන් එකතු වෙන පොදු වේදිකාවක් හැදිලා තියෙනවා.
நீங்கள் கண்டிருப்பீர்கள் ரோமானு கத்தோலிக்க மதகுருமாரும் அந்த கன்னியைகளும் அதே போல வேதத்தை விசுவாசிக்கிறார்கள் என்று சொல்லும் இந்த கரிஸ்மெடிக் கிறிஸ்தவர்களும் ஒரே மேடையில் ஒன்றாக காணப்படுவார்கள். ஆனால் அவர்களுடைய உபதேசங்களை நாங்கள் பார்க்கும் பொழுது அவை ஒன்றுக்கு ஒன்று வேறுபட்டதாக காணப்படுகிறது.
So this is not a major Bible study, but I'm just talking about the present situation. මේ ප්‍රධාන බයිබල් අධ්‍යයනයක් නොවේ වර්තමාන තත්ත්වය ගැන කතා කිරීම.
இது ஒரு பிரதான வேத படிப்பாக அல்ல ஆனால் தற்போது இருக்கும் நிலமையை குறித்து கூறும் ஒரு காரியமாக இருக்கிறது.
So as long as there is one sign that will unite them, maybe it is speaking in tongues, maybe such a common sign, as long as that is possible, everybody can come to the same platform irrespective of their doctrinal beliefs. ඉතින් සමහර විට එක පොදු සාධකයක් පොදු ලක්ෂණයක් සමාන මේ අන්භාෂා කතා කිරීම වැනි ඒ පොදු ලක්ෂණය මුල් කරගෙන හැමදෙනාම එකට එනවා. ඉගැන්වීම් ධර්ම මොනවා වුණත්
අද සිල නේරම් ஒரு පොදු පොதுவான ஒரு அடையாளத்தை கொண்டு அவர்கள் அனைவரும் ஒரே மட்டத்துக்கு ஒரே ஸ்தலத்தில் அவர்கள் ஒன்று சேரக்கூடும்.
See now they come together, worship together and say we are together, we are one, and then go back to their respective places and do things that are contrary to the word of God, the worship of idols, worship of Mary, believing in different gospels. It's all happening, but they are able to come together and be united. ඉතින් බලන්න ඕනේ එකට එකතු වෙලා නමස්කාර කරලා එකට ඉඳලා අපි එකයි කියලා කියලා ඊට පස්සේ විසිරීලා ගිහිල්ලා තම තමාට කැමති දේවල් කරනවා. මරියාන නමස්කාර කිරීම, රූප වලට වැඳ වැටීම, විවිධ ගැළවීම ගැන වෙනම සුභාරංචියක් දේශනා කිරීම, ඒව ඔක්කොම කරන්න කැමති. නමුත් ඔවුන් ඇවිල්ලා එකටත් ඉන්න කැමති අපි පොදුයි කියලා.
அவர்கள் ஒன்றாக சேர்ந்து ஒன்றாக ஆராதித்து நாங்கள் ஒற்றுமையாய் இருக்கிறோம் என்று சொல்லிவிட்டுட்டு அதற்கு பிறகு தங்களுடைய இடங்களுக்கு போய் அவர்களுக்கு வேண்டியபடி இஷ்டப்படி அவர்கள் நடந்து கொள்கிறார்கள். அவர்கள் மரியாதை ஆராதனை செய்கிறார்கள். அவர்கள் தேவதூதர்களை வணங்குகிறார்கள். அவர்கள் ஒரு வேறொரு சுவிசேஷத்தை பின்பற்றுகிறார்கள்.
You may have observed that there are mega Christian movements covering millions of people, gathering millions of people together, but going the wrong way. The doctrinal truths of the Bible are disregarded. ඔබ දැකලා ඇති ක්‍රිස්තියානි විවිධ සංවිධාන මිලියන ගණන් ජනතාවක් එකතු කරගෙන ගමන් කරනවා. නමුත් දේව වචනයේ තිබෙන සත්‍යතාවය නොසලකයි.
நீங்கள் கண்டிருப்பீர்கள் உலகத்தில் பெரிய பெரிய சபைகள் காணப்படுகிறது மில்லியன் கணக்கான மக்களை ஒன்று சேர்த்து அவர்கள் கொண்டு செல்கிறார்கள் ஆனால் வேதத்தில் இருக்கும் உண்மையான உபதேசங்களை புறக்கணித்து விட்டு அவர்கள் அந்த சபை முறையை கையாளுகிறார்கள்.
When the true saints are gone from this world, all the rest of the Christendom will easily come together to make one great harlot, as the Bible says. සැබෑ ශුද්ධවන්තයන් මේ පොළවේ ඉවත් කරගනු ලැබුවායින් පසු ඉතුරු වෙන්නා වූ සියලු ක්‍රිස්තියානි නාමය දරන්නා වූ මුළු ඛණ්ඩායම එකතු වෙනවා සියලු නිකායන් එකතු කරනවා මේ වේශ්‍යාව ගොඩනගන්නට
உண்மையான பரிசுத்த வான்கள் எடுத்துக்கொள்ளப்பட்ட பிறகு மீதியாகும் மற்ற கிறிஸ்தவ பெயர் தரித்தவர்கள் எல்லாரும் ஒன்று சேர்ந்து இந்த வேசி என்ற காரியத்தை அவர்கள் நிரூபிப்பார்கள்.
Yes, the official church of the Roman Empire persecuted the saints. They actually drunk with the blood of the saints. மீ නිලමය වශයෙන් වූ රෝම අධිරාජ්‍යයේ සභාව ඒ කාලේ සැබෑ ඇදහිලිවන්තයන් ව පීඩාවට පත් කළා. ඇත්තෙන්ම ඔවුන් ශුද්ධවන්තයන්ගේ ලේවලින් මත්වෙලා ඉන්නේ.
අකාලෙත් කාණපට රෝම ආධිකත්වයේ සභයானது உண்மையாவே பரிசுத்தவான்களை துன்புறுத்தி அவர்களுடைய இரத்தத்தினால் வெறிகொண்டு காணப்பட்டது.
Doctrinally, these organizations are far away from the truth. සත්‍යතාවයට අනුව මේ ඉගැන්වීම් වලට අනුව මේවැනි කණ්ඩායම් සත්‍යතාවෙන් බොහෝ ඈත් වෙලා ඉන්නේ.
සත්‍ය උපදේශයෙන් පරි ඉන්න විදමාන කුලුකල් සත්‍යයෙන්ලෙන්ද එබලවෝ ප්‍රොමේ පොයිරකාර්කල්.
Salvation is found only in the Lord Jesus Christ and him alone. By the grace of God we are saved. ගැලවීම ඇත්තේ ස්වාමී වූ යේසුස් ක්‍රිස්තුස් වහන්සේ තුල පමණයි. දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ අනුග්‍රහය හරහා අපි ගැලවීම ලබනවා.
රක්ෂිත කාණපඩுகிறது ආණ්ඩවරාගිය යේසු ක්‍රිස්තුවකල් මාත්‍රමේ අවරුඩේ කිරුබයිනාලේ නාගල් රක්ෂිකපට්ටිරුකරෝ.
Anything that is added to that truth of the grace of God will make it invalid. It cannot save you. යම් දෙයක් ඒ සත්‍යතාවය දෙවියන් වහන්සේගේ අනුග්‍රහයේ සත්‍යතාවට යමත්ව එකතු කළොත් එකවතාවේ මේක අවලංගු වෙනවා. ඒකෙන් ඔබව ගැළවීමට ගෙනෙන්න බෑ.
දෙවියන්ගේ කිරුබේ என்ற සත්‍යයේ ஏதாவது சேர்க்கப்பட்டால் அது ප්‍රයෝජනමත්දයි. උங்களை රක්ෂிக்க முடியாத ஒரு காரியமாய் ஆகிறது.
You are not saved by belonging to a particular denomination. You are saved by believing in the Lord Jesus Christ. ඔබ ගැළවීම ලබන්නේ යම් කිසි නිකායකට අයිති වීම කරනකොටගෙන නොවේ. ඔබ ගැළවීම ලබන්නේ ස්වාමී වූ යේසුස් වහන්සේ අදහා ගැනීමෙන්.
நீங்கள் ரட்சிக்கப்படுவது ஏதாவது ஒரு குழுவுக்கு சேர்வதன் பிரிவினைக்கு சேர்வதன் மூலம் அல்ல ஆனால் ஆண்டவராகிய இயேசு கிறிஸ்துவை விசுவாசிப்பதன் மூலமே.
So during the tribulation time, this woman, this religious system, this harlot becomes a prominent factor in the world carried by the beast. ඉතින් පීඩා කාලය තුලදී මේ ස්ත්‍රිය නැමැති මේ ආගමික පද්ධතිය මේ ප්‍රධාන ස්ථානයට එන්න යනවා මුර්ගයා විසින් උසුලාගෙන යනු ලබන
උපත්‍රව කාලத்துக்குள்ள இந்த ஸ்திரீ என்று சொல்லப்படுகிற இந்த மத அமைப்பானது அந்த மிருகத்தினால் கொண்டு செல்லப்படுகிற இந்த மத அமைப்பானது ஒரு பிரசித்தமான இடத்துக்கு வரப்போகிறது.
But what happens is that same beast, that political system and the leader will destroy finally that world church, so that the only object of worship would be the beast himself. නමුත් සිදුවන ඊළඟදී නම් මෙන්න මේකයි. ඒ මුර්ගයා විසින් ඒ දේශපාලන සංවිධානයේ නායකත්වයේදී මුර්ගයා විසින් එම ස්ත්‍රිය විනාශ කරනු ලබනවා. සම්පූර්ණයෙන්ම නැති කරනවා. එවිට நமஸ்காரை லபென்னே முருகையாட பமணப்பவன பிரிசு
ஆனால் நடைபெறும் காரியம் என்னவென்றால் இந்த அரசியல் அமைப்புள்ள இந்த மிருகமே இந்த ஸ்திரியை அழித்து போடுவான் ஏனென்றால் கடைசியாக ஆராதனை செலுத்தக்கூடிய தகுதியுள்ளவனாக இந்த மிருகம் காணப்படும்
Chapter 17, verse 16. Dahatai Dase.
Padinala Madiharam Padinaram Vasanam.
And the 10 horns which thou sawest upon the beast, these shall hate the war, and shall make her desolate and naked, and shall eat her flesh and burn her with fire. Menna. E Andase Attavu E Murdia. Me Veshyavada Vailagarla. ऐवन आस्ति करला, ऐवन इन्वस्ट करला, अगे मांशे खा दमला, ऐव गिन्निन दवा दमनो।
पदिनार आमसनम नी मिर्गतीन मेल खंड पत्त कुंभुगल आन अवरगल, अंदे वेसिये पहित अवले पालु निर्वाण माखी, अवलुडे मांसते पचित अवले निरपिल सुट्टेरित पोडवारगल।
So this religious establishment that will emerge at the beginning of the tribulation period, will have its final form of this religion, apostate Christendom, only for a short time. It will be completely destroyed by the beast. So that the purpose is that only the beast could be worshipped thereafter. Iti me agamika samvidhanaya pida kalaya muladi arambha vela e ita vishala sthanayakata gaurawayata bhajane vela කතුමෙලා හැබැයි ඊළඟට මුර්ගයා විසින් විනාශ කරනවා මොකද මුර්ගයා තමයි අන්තිමට নমස්කාරය ඉල්ලන එකම එක්කනවා
ඉද උපත්‍රව කාලයෙන් මුත්පෞදීල් ඉඳ මද අමෛප්පු උරුවාහි අද මෙහෙවුම් ප්‍රසිද්ධම් පෙරම් ආනාල් මිරගතිනාලේ අද අලිත් පොඩපඩුම් ஏனென்றால் கடைசியில் ஆராதனை பெற்றுக்கொள்ள தகுதியான விதத்தில் மிருகம் மாத்திரமே காணப்பட வேண்டும் என்பதால்
So this is the general idea that we can take from this passage. It speaks to us of the ecclesiastical Babylon, religious Babylon, that will be seen in the last days. දැන් ඒ නිසා 17 පරිච්ඡේදය අපිට තේරුම් ගන්න තිබෙන්නේ මේක ආගමික සිද්ධාන්ත මත ගොඩනැගුණා වූ බබිලෝනියක් හැටියට තමයි ගන්න වෙන්නේ අවසාන කාලයේදී පැනනගින්නා වූ ආගමික බබිලෝනිය.
අදාල 17වද අධිහාරත්තින් විලක්කම ඉදතාන් නාගල எடுத்துக்கொள்ள கூடிய காரியம் என்னவென்றால் கடைசி காலத்தில் ஒரு மத அமைப்போடு உருவாகும் காரியமாகவே இந்த பாபிலோன் காணப்படுகிறது.
Then we also have the description is continuing with a different color and flavor thereafter, suggesting to us the political and the commercial Babylon and its fall. ඉතින් ඊට පස්සේ මේ බබිලෝනිය ගැන විස්තරය තවදුරටත් යනවා. හැබැයි ටිකක් වෙනස් වර්ණයක් සහ වෙනස් රසයක් ඇතුව. ඒකෙන් අපිට යෝජනා කරනවා එතනින් කතාව යන්නේ දේශපාලනීය සහ வாணிஜ்யமே பபிலோனிய பிலிபதவை கேள்
நாங்கள் காண்டோம் இதை தொடர்ந்தும் இந்த பாபிலோனியுடைய கதையானது முன்செல்லுகிறது வேறொரு ருசியும் வேறொரு வர்ணத்தோடு அதில் அதன் மூலம் அரசியல் ரீதியான பாபிலோனும் வர்த்தக பாபிலோனை குறித்தும் அங்கே கூறப்படுகிறது
So dear brothers and sisters, once again we come back to the same question. As people who know these things, the future of this world, what are we doing as believers? Are we ready to be caught up? Minsa sahodara sahodariyani kathave avasane aapasu api enne parana prashneyatama me sielu deval dannawu api me polave shuddhavantayan wenna kandewwaamu api இயேசுப் பான்சே விஷயம் உசவாகணு லபீமட சூதானம்ல
இந்த கதையின் கடைசியில் நாங்கள் மீண்டுமாக அந்த முதல் கேட்ட கேள்விக்கே வருகிறோம் இவற்றை யாவற்றையும் அறிந்திருக்கிற நாம் கிறிஸ்து இயேசுவினுடைய வருகைக்கு ஆயத்தமாய் காணப்படுகிறோமா
May I also in closing exhort you to read chapter 17 and 18 several times before we consider them or further discuss them tomorrow, God willing. මේ නිසා මා අවසාන වශයෙන් ඔබට කියන්නේ මේ 17-18 පරිච්ඡේද යලිත් නැවත නැවතත් කියමු මෙනෙහි කරන්න තේරුම් ගන්න උත්සාහ ගන්න අපි හෙට දවසේදී යලිත් යම් කරුණු කිහිපයක් මේ පිළිබඳව සලකා බලන්ට යනවා මේ එම අධ්‍යයනයේ මේ කොටස අවසන් කරන්න පෙර ආතුර
මුින්න මහවලටම කටකොලරෙන් 17 18 ආනම් 8ම් වසනංගලේ தயவுசெய்து மீண்டும் மீண்டுமாக வாசித்து விளங்கிக் கொள்ள முயற்சி செய்யுங்கள். கடவுளுக்கு சித்தமானால் நாங்கள் நாளைய தினத்தில் அதை குறித்து மேலதிக சில விவரங்களை கவனிப்போம்.
Shall we pray? Our gracious loving Father, Lord, we thank you for being with us today. We thank you for the word of God that you have given into our hands. As we look around at the world, yes, we can, Lord, draw a parallel. There is this harlot, Babylon, emerging around us in Christendom. Ecumenism is so prominently projected and promoted, advertised. But Lord, we know that the truth of thy word is far more important than anything else. There are certain uniting factors that are sweeping across all the Christian denominations in the world. But Lord, we know when they are not according to the word of God, this is more or less the fulfillment of what is written in Revelation chapter 17. Babylon the great, the mother of harlots and abominations of the earth, is in the making, embracing other religions as well, finally will have its part in the final form of religion in the world. O God, help us that we may understand this danger, that we may keep ourselves from such defilement, that we may value the truth of the gospel, truth of the gospel of the grace of God, and we may value salvation wrought by the Lord Jesus on the cross, and that salvation alone. Keep us, Lord, very simple but exactly according to the word of God, that we may hold the truth of the word of God very dear. We may become unpopular, disliked by others, but help us, Lord, that we may be willing to go through that experience. Gracious loving Father, we pray for all the people in the world who name the name of Christ, irrespective of their denominational allegiance, they may turn to you. O God, turn to the Lord Jesus for salvation. They may see the word of God, and everything may become new in their lives. Save those whom thou hast chosen out of every denomination. Those who are not saved may be brought into salvation, become part of the bride of Christ. Loving Heavenly Father, we cannot change these big denominations or big organizations. Help, Lord, that individuals may be saved, that they may turn to thee for salvation. The time is short. They are almost, what is written in Revelation chapter 17 is almost upon us. So help us that we may walk faithful. Accept our thanksgiving in the name of our loving Savior, the Lord Jesus Christ, we pray. Amen.